Hello, back again to the third part of the Mackie Control Unit video series for Bitwig. And in the third part, I'm gonna show you a new device, which is called the Icon Qcon Pro X. And it also speaks the Mackie Control protocol, but it has some additions to it. One of it is, for example, it has a stereo master view up there, and there is also a second display. And because these things are not in a normal MCU protocol, Bitwig is currently, with my extension, the only DAW which supports the second display and also the VU meters. And this is quite helpful because having only one display is pretty limiting with the original MCU. So what I did is, you always see here in the lower part what is the name of your channels. So you can always can leave the upper part of your display set to what's going on with your knobs. So what are you controlling with your knobs? And you always see what is the channel you're modifying in a second display. So quite handy. What I also display is there always what is the selected track, so the name of the selected track, and also the name of a selected device you can currently edit. The left part is quite similar to the original MCU, so you have your faders here. They will also select the channel if you touch them. You have your selection knobs, mute, solo, and the record state, and you can change the knobs, and you also have this feature to set it to its default value when you press it. A little bit different is the right hand part. Also the navigation part is quite similar, but this part is different. And the nice thing is that with the icon there comes a specific overlay, especially for Bitwig. Hey, great. And if you put it on, I assigned now those buttons that they exactly do what they say on this nice overlay. And for example, you can change here what you want to do. So you have here the track, then you can change panorama, you can change the sense, and you can edit your devices. So I don't have a device selected. I have one, but it doesn't have parameters. So like with the other one, we can use that to switch our projects. I go to the first project, and there I have I activate it. And in that one, I have a device selected, which is, let's go to the first track here. And in that track, I have a polysynth. And if I go now to device, I can edit that device. And same is that you can open up the browser. And here it's also called the browser. So if I press the browse button, I get my browser and can browse my presets of the polysynth. The same is, you can leave it with the enter knob. You also have your automation knobs. You have different utilities to show and hide different parts. And what I forgot also in the other video is the second display, or the third, however you want to count it, display we have there, which gives you the transport position of your song. And you have an option here to toggle between the tempo here. So you have a very detailed view, or you can toggle that to tempo. So you see here, this is the tempo of your song. So the current song is 110 BPM, and yeah, you can choose whatever you prefer to see. So, and if I play back this project, you see the stereo view is also working quite nicely with the device. So thanks for watching so much for the series about the MCU protocol, which is now available in a new version for Bitwig. And make some funky music!